Hello everyone, good to see you again. In this video, we are going to build some glass, actually. We're going to build a glass partition across the middle here, as well as apply some glass to our windows and our skylight up there, because we don't want it to rain on us, and it would be nice to have glass up there. So let's go ahead and start doing that. First thing we need is a piece of glass. So inside of our starter content and props folder, we have this SM glass window. So let's go ahead and drag that in. And it's pretty dark again because we killed our working light. I guess we could have kept that in here, which actually I'm just gonna pop it back in just for now. So I'm gonna hold L and left click in here to get a quick little working light there. Gonna go to the drop down, lock viewport to actor and point light. And there we go, there's our working light again. Okay, with that, let's select our glass piece here. Actually, I do want to mention something. By default, you should be able to select this. If for some reason you cannot and you are accidentally selecting it through it, like so, selecting the wall behind it, you may have turned off the translucency selection. You can get to that by pressing the T key. So if I press T, it's on right now and I can select this translucent piece of glass here. But if I press T, I will select actually right through it and select the objects behind it. So just a quick handy tool if you have not been able to select it, go ahead and press T and you can select it. You can also get to that through the quick settings. There's an option right here, allow translucent selection, and its hotkey is T, as we mentioned. And there you go, just allows you to select or not select translucent objects. So we have our piece. Let's go ahead and let's rotate it actually. Let's press E, go into rotation mode and rotate it 90 degrees. And W to go back into move mode. And we're gonna place it against this wall over here, like so. Something, actually let's pop it up into the air first for a second and press end. And let's move it over so that it is right on the line there. Look at that. That is pretty nice. So we have it right on the line there in the middle. We need to scale it up because it's obviously not big enough. So I'm gonna hit R to go into scale mode. And let's try and scale it up uniformly here. And it is exactly going into our roof or pillar beam there. Let's go to the scale snapping. Let's turn that off. Let's turn off scale snapping altogether so that we can kind of get the exact size that we want, because we're also going to lift it up off the floor a little bit. So let's go to press W and move it up a little bit too, so that it is off the floor a little bit, like so. And if we go up, a little bit of a gap there as well. I think that's fine. It doesn't have to be flush with the floor and the pillar up there, so I think that's good. So leave a little bit of a gap, and let's move it over just a little bit more, like so. And again, we can have a gap here too. Most office buildings, when they have like a glass partition like this, they don't necessarily have to have the pieces flush with the walls and the floor. So let's go ahead and leave it like this. That's fine. Let's actually put in some frame holders for this so that it's just not floating in air like that. We're gonna go into the content browser and use the SM corner frame for that. So let's drag one of those into our level here. And it's kind of big. Let's actually press E and rotate it first, 90 degrees, like so. And then let's also press W real quick to go back to movement. Let's also scale it down. We're just gonna punch in values for this manually. Let's click this little lock icon here so that it scales uniformly. And let's set this to 0.5. And that will set it to 0.5 for the others as well. So that looks a lot better. Okay, let's go ahead and rotate it just a little bit so that it is... Actually, you know what? Let's rotate it. We don't need to rotate it. I think it looks good like that. So you got the back end, and then... Yeah, that looks good to me. We'll leave it just like that. So let's press W and move it over to the edge of this glass piece here, and let's move it up near it. It's clipping into it a little bit. I think that's okay. I think that's fine because it's just holding our frame up here. Our grid snapping is set to 5. We could bump this down to 1 if we wanted. Let's try that. Bump it down to 1 and move it just on the edge like so, ever so perfectly. I think that's good. Let's do it like that. Let's put our grid snapping, let's put it to 10 actually, because we're going to need it in a moment when we add the rest of these pieces. So with that piece in place, we're going to hold Alt and drag up a copy to the top, like so. And let's press E to rotate it this way, like so. And W to move it up. And grid snapping, yeah, we're always changing this, I know. Let's change it back to 1 and make sure that it is somewhat closer to the top there. Something. Now we don't want to move it off its axis. We do want to have it even with that. So I'm going to delete it. Sorry. I'm going to just reselect it and Alt drag it up again and then just rotate it. That's good enough. 180 degrees. W to move tool. Good enough. Getting too nitpicky here. So with that, we do need to make sure that it is on the ceiling though. So let's go ahead and do that. Like that. And let's select our glass piece and move it up just a little bit. Like that. Good enough. So let's go ahead and control select both of these and press W to go to the move tool. Then Alt drag over a copy of those, like so. And let's zoom in and see how they look. Pretty good. Doesn't have to be exact. That is good. Okay, let's go ahead and select all 4 of them. And then we're going to hold Alt. Or you know what, let's press E. Hold Alt and rotate out a copy of them. 90 degrees, and press W, and move those into place. Something like this. Let's see how they are lined up. Ah, brightness light, darn you. Gonna uncheck our light real quick. And get out of here, light. Just so I can look at this. So let's see, let's select all of them again really quickly. Probably a better view down here. Just making sure that they're lined up, which they are. Okay, with that, let's hold Control and select the other ones. And then let's select our glass piece and Control G to group them so that we have one entity of a glass piece here. And with that, let's hold Alt and drag over a copy, leaving a little space in between. And let's select both of those and Alt drag over a copy, like so. And let's do one more, because right here is where we're going to have our door. So let's Alt drag over one more. And then one more. And for this one, because it's not gonna quite fit another one in there, just a little bit off, I'm gonna delete that one. Yes, go ahead and delete all of those. For this one, we're actually just gonna stretch it. It's gonna be a little bit longer than the other pieces, which sometimes you see that in office buildings. They don't have to be all exactly the same size. So for this one, we're just gonna hit or hold Shift and press G to ungroup them. I'm gonna select our glass piece. Going to press R to go into scale mode, and then grabbing this green one, we're just going to stretch it out, pulling it to the right to stretch it out. Something like that. Okay, and let's grab our corner pieces here. Press W to select each of those. Then press T to turn off translucency so I can select the one behind it. And now we have each of our corner pieces. Let's just move those over to this side. So there we go. That looks good enough. You know what? Let's hold turn on translucency real quick by pressing T, then Shift G. We're actually going to delete these corner frames on these because this is going to be our movable glass piece and we don't want corner frames on them. So go ahead and delete the corner frames on this piece. We don't need them. Again, T to turn off translucency selection so I can get the one behind it. And that one, and that one, and that one. And we'll worry about, we'll add a track and stuff for our sliding door in the next video. For now, this is fine. The last bit of business that we have is to add windows and our skylight window as well. So let's go ahead and take this piece that we have here. Well, first of all, let's go back to translucency selection by pressing T and select this piece that we have here. And let's hold Alt and drag over a copy into our wall over here. Fly over there. And let's position it inside our window frame here. Something like so. Now, we could just leave it like this inside of our window. I mean, that's totally fine. But I'm being nitpicky, so I'm going to rescale this by pressing R. And let's uniformly scale it down just a little bit. And then W to move it up. And move it over. Like so. A little bit of a gap there. So let's press R to go into scale. Pull out this green one. W. And move it over. That's better. I mean, it's still clipping in, but it's not taking up this whole space like it was before. Totally fine to do it the other way, but I'm just going to rescale it just for the purposes of practicing rescaling and switching between tools. So with that, let's hold Alt, start dragging this copy over, then press Shift and hold Shift to move the camera and position this glass piece inside this window. So there we go. We have glass inside both of our windows. We need our skylight up there. So I'm actually just going to add another piece. So let's just drag in another glass window to the lip of this window seal here, like so. I'm going to fly up here and look at it from the top. Let's press E to rotate and rotate it along this axis down 90 degrees. And let's press R to scale, like so. W to move it over. R to switch back to scale and move it over. W. And close. Let's see. Looks good to me. Nope, because it's down a little bit. Let's pull it up into the frame a little bit better, like so. So there we go. We have added our glass partition. We have added some windows and our glass for the skylight. I think that's a good stopping point. We'll break here in the next video. We will start working on the sliding glass door using some blueprints, and we will see you in the next video.